I, Joseph Robinette Biden Jr., do solemnly swear.
After taking the oath of office, President Joseph R. Biden declared democracy has prevailed.
I will be a president for all Americans. All Americans.
Former Presidents Barack Obama, George W. Bush, and Bill Clinton were on hand for the transfer of power, as well as outgoing Vice President Mike Pence.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Pence's successor, Kamala Harris, made history, becoming not only the first woman, but the first black person and first person of South Asian descent to become vice president. Speaking at the Capitol just 2 weeks after rioters stormed the building, the 46th president said unity is the only path forward.
My whole soul is in this, bringing America together, uniting our people, uniting our nation. And I ask every American to join me in this cause.
Well, today was steeped in tradition. Only a small, socially distanced group attended the ceremony because of the coronavirus pandemic and increased security concerns.
The National Mall, usually crowded with supporters, was instead filled with flags. On stage, an array of star power.
Amazing Grace.
Notably absent, former President Donald Trump, who declined to greet his successor as he hinted at a political return.
We will be back in some form. I wish the new administration great luck and great success.
Following a gift exchange with congressional leaders, President Biden and Vice President Harris attended a wreath laying at the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier at Arlington National Cemetery. The president and first lady then kicked off the mostly virtual inaugural parade with a walk along Pennsylvania Avenue. Natalie Brand, CBS News, Washington.